Hello friends, and welcome to this tutorial of Cape Open to Cape Open Simulator. Today we will learn how to simulate a flash drum. Now what is a flash drum? A flash drum separates a stream into vapor and liquid. Now what happens exactly in a flash drum is that any stream that enters into the flash drum is flashed into a vapor and a liquid. Now the vapor and liquid are at equilibrium. This is the most important thing to understand. Now how do we simulate this operation using a Cape Open to Cape Open simulator? Well, we can see an example. So let's solve an example for this. The example is from Separation Process Principles, Cedar and Henley, second edition, problem number 2.6, particular page 47. The reactor effluent of an hydroalkylation reactor has a pressure of 3448 kilopascals, a temperature of 408.2 Kelvin, a flow of 5597 kilomolar hour. The hydrogen concentration is 0.3177. The methane concentration is 0.5894, the benzene concentration is 0.0715, and the toluene concentration is 0.0214. The stream that comes from the hydroalkylation reactor is cooled and partially condensed at 322 Kelvin. The steam is then separated in a flash drum at 3344 kilopascals. We have to find the flow and the composition of the liquid and the vapor leaving the flash drum. Also, we have to calculate the heat required to cool the reactor effluent. The thermodynamics that we will be using is Peng-Robinson equation of state. So let's go ahead and solve the example. Let us begin with the problem now. I have already configured the thermodynamics. So I will select it. As you can see, the compounds hydrogen, methane, benzene and toluene are loaded. And the equation of state is Peng-Robinson equation of state. Let us first draw the feed stream and name it as feed. The pressure is given in kilopascals, so we change the units to kilopascals. And the temperature, we leave it as it is because it is in Kelvin. The pressure is 3448 kilopascals. The temperature is 408.2 Kelvin. The hydrogen mole fraction is 0.3177. The methane mole fraction is 0.5894. The benzene mole fraction is 0.7715. And the toluene mole fraction automatically gets calculated. The flow to the separator is 5594. It is kilomoles per hour. So we will have to change the units here and re-enter it. So we change the mass to kilomole and the time to hour, and we re-enter the flow. 5,497. Now we close this window and we click run. Once we double click the stream, we see that the phase fraction is that of vapor. So it is a vapor stream, and now we need to condense it. The temperature at which we need to condense it is 322 Kelvin. Now I will use a heat exchanger to condense this stream, as it is a convention in plants to do this. So you take the heater, cooler, operation, unit operation. Join the feed to the heater. So this is a cooler. Since it brings down the temperature, we rename it as cooler. And then we draw the outlet stream of the cooler. We rename stream number 2 as cooler outlet. Now we double click on the cooler. It is known that the temperature at the outlet of the cooler is 322 Kelvin. So we click edit and we click outlet temperature and we close this window. Now we can change the outlet temperature here on this window. So the units are changed to Celsius. No, the units are in Kelvin. So we retain the Kelvin and we enter the outlet temperature as 322 Kelvin and we click enter. Once again, we run the simulation. Double click on the outlet and the temperature is 322 Kelvin and the temperature pressure is 3448 kilopascals. Now here what we find is that the phase has split. The stream has a vapor and a liquid. Now we need to separate this vapor and liquid which is in the cooler outlet stream. For this, we select a separator, a flash separator. And we put the flash separator on the flow sheet and connect the cooler outlet to the flash separator. We again click the stream and draw a stream on the top of the flash outlet. We connect the top stream to the vapor port. Click connect. We again select a stream and attach it to the bottom of the flash. Now this automatically gets connected to the liquid. So we rename the top stream as flash vapor and the bottom as flash liquid. We double click the flash unit operation and click on edit. Now here what is known? Now 3344 kilopascal is our outlet pressure at the flash drum. So we click outlet pressure and then the outlet temperature is also known. So we click the radio button of the outlet temperature and we close the window. Now we can see here, we can re-enter our outlet pressure here on this window. So we click on pressure and we change the units to kilopascal and we click on temperature and we keep the units of temperature as it is. Now we enter the pressure, the outlet pressure in the window, that is 3344 kilopascals, and the outlet temperature, that is 3000, that is 322 Kelvin. Close the window and we run the simulation. Now we find this error. Double click it, go to status, and we see the message. The message is flash temperature post check failed for liquid product, temperature deviation too high using TP flash. You can either accept the warning or go to the simulation once again by clicking graphic user interface options and click on use TP flash rather than pressure volume fluid flash. That is pressure volume flash. BVF stands for pressure volume flash calculation for the outlet streams. Now, since we know the temperature and pressure of the outlet, we should click on this as yes. Close it and re-simulate. Now the simulation has run successfully. Now let us click and find what is the amount of liquid that we have. The flow rate of liquid is 473.75 kilomoles per hour, and it majorly consists of benzene and toluene. We double click on the vapor. The flow rate of the vapor is 5123 kilomoles per hour, and it majorly consists of hydrogen and methane and a little amount of benzene and toluene. Therefore, the stream which has come at the inlet of the flash has been separated off, where the majority is the non-condensable gases which go on the top, and at the bottom we have the condensable liquid with a little amount of non-condensable gases dissolved in it. This is how we simulate the flash vapor liquid equilibrium or the flash unit operation. I have put an exchanger at the inlet of the flash. I may have eliminated this cooler altogether and connected this feed directly to the flash. It is possible. In this case, the load that is calculated here will be calculated in this unit operation itself. So we can try doing it. Now the load here is 9.5891 megawatts. The minus sign indicates that the heat has to be removed. Let's keep a note of this figure, -9.5891 megawatts. Now let's delete the cooler outlet stream and let's delete the heat exchanger and reconnect the feed stream to the flash unit operation. Now we again click run simulation and it has successfully simulated. Now let us go back and double click on the flash unit operation. As we can see here, the load has been calculated. It is -9.566 megawatts, which was equivalent to what we had as the cooler load. So either we put a cooler at the inlet or we do not put it, it does not make a difference. The calculation gives you the same results. In a flash unit operation, you can calculate what is the vapor flow rate, what is the liquid flow rate, and how much the heat needs to be removed or added to cause the flashing. The flash can be isothermal, the flash can be adiabatic, or the flash can be in between the isothermal and adiabatic flash, where heat need to be either removed or added to the flash drum. In all three modes or in all three ways, the load will always be calculated and you will successfully get what are the flow rates at the outlet of the flash. Thanks for watching the video and have a great day. If you have any queries, do write to me. Do put it in the comments of YouTube. And if you like the video, press like. Your like motivates me to make more such videos which would educate you on how to use Cape Open to Cape Open Simulator. Goodbye.